Welcome back. This week we are talking about the final step in the IVF process.
The embryo transfer.
Yeah, and just in case this is your first time meeting us, I'm Kurt. I'm a board certified pediatrician and supportive partner.
I'm Sarah. I am a board certified OBGYN, a fertility specialist, and now an IVF patient myself.
And we are the Doctors Bjorkman.
Week we are talking all about the embryo transfer, what it is, how it's performed, and what to expect.
Yeah, embryo transfer day is a really special day.
Yeah.
It's this culmination of weeks of injections, ultrasounds, you've got a minor surgical procedure, possibly you did genetic testing, and all of this has happened after a long battle with infertility.
Yeah. So it really is an exciting and nerve-wracking day. And the preparation for it depends on whether you're doing a fresh versus a frozen embryo transfer.
Yeah, a fresh transfer means you're doing this transfer about 5 days after your retrieval.
Yep. And a frozen transfer means that after your retrieval, the embryos were created and then frozen to be transferred at some point in the future. This is done for a variety of reasons. You know, you may have a big response to a stimulation, you may have planned genetic testing, or it may just be the way your clinic does it.
Yeah. And fresh or frozen, the lead up to transfer may be a bit different, but the day of is very much the same for either.
Indeed. Whichever you're doing, fresh or frozen, it is very important that you are taking your medications and following kind of your calendar or protocol as prescribed.
Yeah, and the meds here are very important for getting your uterine lining ready for this transfer.
Yes. So things to think about ahead of time are to make sure that you know what time your procedure is and what time you need to arrive at the clinic. You're going to want to know what the clinic policy is on visitors or having a partner with you. And then you want to find out if you need any labs or anything else done the day of that procedure. So what to expect on the day of your transfer. So the day of, the team is going to ask you to come with a full bladder.
Yeah, and why is that?
So the first reason is that a full bladder really helps us be able to see when we are using the transabdominal ultrasound. We want to be able to look through your abdominal wall and be able to see the uterus clearly, and that fluid helps with visualization. The second reason is that a full bladder often helps kind of straighten out your uterus so that there's a nice straight path for the catheter.
Now, there are a lot of people involved with the transfer day.
Yep.
Usually there's a nurse, the physician, the embryologist, and a sonographer.
So when you arrive at the clinic, usually a nurse is going to have you get undressed from the waist down. They review any labs you have had done. You also might not need any. And then you're going to meet the rest of the team. Your physician will usually sign a consent form for the procedure. They will do multiple checks to confirm your identity and do this confirmation checks with the lab. And then the embryologist or doc will kind of go over your embryo report with you. If it's a fresh transfer, they may give you a rundown of what's happened over the past 5 days. So how many eggs were retrieved, how many fertilized normally, and then show you that blastocysts or embryos that have made it to day 5 and which one you're going to transfer.
Yeah. If it's a frozen transfer, they'll have a picture of your embryo and share how it survived the thaw process, and then it's time to get ready for the procedure.
Yes. So let's talk about the embryo transfer. So the procedure, the embryo transfer itself, is a very safe and simple procedure. To start out, a speculum is placed in the vagina, just like when you get a pap smear.
But what if someone's had difficult speculum exams in the past?
So that's something you definitely want to let your team know, because often we can give you some Valium ahead of time to help you relax, help your uterus and pelvic floor muscles relax, and to help you be more comfortable. This is in addition to knowing ahead of time, we can often use a different, more smaller speculum and things like that to help make it better for you. So after the speculum is placed, we're going to clean the cervix off with a cotton ball and some saline. We then do a quick practice with the catheter to make sure we have a nice smooth path to the uterus.
And this is the transfer catheter.
Yes, yes it is. So as you can see, it is a small, flexible catheter that we gently thread through the cervix, okay? So it kind of, it has an outer sheath here and then this inner soft catheter.
Yeah. And all of this is being done with ultrasound guidance.
Correct. So once we know we have a nice smooth path, we let the embryologist know, we remove this inner catheter, and we have the embryologist load that embryo up in this soft inner catheter. That outer catheter usually stays there to hold the path. And so we then thread that inner catheter back through the outer catheter until we get to a specific spot up in your uterus, kind of at the thickest portion of the lining. And then we do the transfer. So we have this small syringe that is filled with some fluid that we gently inject. And often as that is happening, your doc will let you know, hey, we're doing the transfer. And you often see a flash, a bright flash on the ultrasound. So the embryo is microscopic, so we can't see that, but when the embryologist is loading up the embryo, they put one air bubble in front of the embryo and one behind it. So that when you inject, you see the flashes, and those are those air bubbles that were loaded with your embryo.
Well, it's transfer day. Here we go.
Send baby dust.
Wish us luck. Bye.
After that, the physician then slowly removes the catheter, and then the embryologist is able to check the catheter to make sure that the embryo didn't get stuck in the catheter itself.
Correct. So every once in a while, the embryo does stick in the catheter. And so if that happens, the embryologist loads the embryo back up and we do the transfer again until we know it is in the right place in your uterus.
Yeah. And then once the embryologist gives you the all clear, it is okay to either rest for a little bit or get up and go pee.
Yes. There is no data that suggests that a prolonged period of rest or laying supine, putting your hips up, things like that, increases your chances of pregnancy. So I think our patients usually hang out for about 5 minutes and then they're on their way.
Yeah. After the transfer, it is really important to keep taking your medications as prescribed.
Yes. And then usually 10 days after the transfer, it is time to take your pregnancy test.
Now that pregnancy test, that's a blood test?
Yes. Your clinic will want to get a blood test or a quantitative HCG. So that is a number. They usually repeat that after 48 hours to make sure it's rising appropriately.
Hmm. Well, how early can you take that test, or can you use home tests?
So generally, your clinic is gonna recommend waiting until 10 days after and getting the blood test. So this is for a couple of reasons. One, getting a negative home pregnancy test can be just emotionally tough. And two, it might just be wrong that you're just testing too early. That being said, I know many patients, myself included, start testing earlier. So we have a video all about how early you can take a pregnancy test and signs of implantation and early pregnancy coming your way next week. So hopefully that is everything you need to know about the embryo transfer. If you have any questions, tips, anything, please leave them below. If you are getting ready for your embryo transfer, sending you all the luck and baby dust. We will see you next week.
Bye guys.
There is this sort of voodoo or myth or whatever that there's absolutely no evidence for, that if you eat french fries after your embryo transfer, you're more likely to get pregnant. And so again, while there's no evidence for it, I like french fries. I'm really trying to embrace all this. So here we go.
We're doctors.
But not your doctors.
Anything we've said in this video is for education or entertainment purposes only.
It is not medical advice.
Any specific medical questions you have should be directed to your provider.